Hey guys, welcome back again to Ken Tamplin Vocal Academy, where the proof is in the singing. I'm doing a series called What Makes This Singer Great? And next up is Adam Lambert. Before we get started, if you wouldn't mind, please like and subscribe to my channel. That'd be really cool. Don't forget to ring that bell so I can keep more cool videos coming your way. And I have a singing course, and the course is called How to Sing Better Than Anyone Else. You can find it right here at kentamplinvocalacademy.com, where we do takedowns of all these different singers, and we talk about different techniques and styles and whatnot of all the greats in hopes to help make you great at singing. So with that said, what do I think of when I think of Adam Lambert? Well, of course, I think of American Idol for starters, right? He didn't win. I think of that, that the judges must have been wrong, or maybe America was wrong, whoever didn't vote for him to actually win. I think of his high range throughout American Idol and sort of that what gave him the notoriety and the edge on other people. I think of his flamboyance, you know? I think of him just being very flamboyant and very, you know, theatrical. I think of the fact, obviously, that he's the singer for Queen. He's a great singer. Now, I want to put a little caveat on the side of this because I get asked this all the time, and I'm just going to put it out there, okay? Do I think he's as good as Freddie Mercury? No way. Not even close. No offense, guys. If you're an Adam Lambert fan and you're going to get some hate mail, bring it on, because it's just the truth. And here's why. Now, I'm here to talk about what makes him great, not what doesn't make him great. I'll get to that in a second. But come on. Freddie, first of all, invented Freddie, number one. Number two, Freddie's compositions and his musicianship and his songwriting just in general, not just arrangement, orchestration, but his actual songwriting was just off the charts. I mean, it was like once in a lifetime we're going to see a Freddie Mercury, right? So I'm not seeing Adam write those kinds of pieces, that kind of composition, that kind of orchestration, piano playing, including all this together. So, but what does make Adam exceptional is the fact that he could step into Freddie's shoes and fill it. That is remarkable. So absolute kudos to him for that. Now, he has a little bit of a different style. And in fact, in some ways, he may have more vocal calisthenics than Freddie. I mean, he's got probably more live range than Freddie did. Maybe not range on a record per se, but live range. And one of the things that I think of when I think of Adam is early on in American Idol, he did the song Mad World, and I never really liked that song originally until he did it. And so his reinterpretation of that song for me was really cool, because I was like, wow, I love that. That was good. And it was kind of haunting. I almost wanted to like do my own version of it, because he inspired me that much in the song. So I think he even got a standing ovation from Simon out of that, if I'm not mistaken. But anyway, so those are the things I think of. So I think of range, I think of power, I think of he loves vocal riffs and runs, you know, that's a thing for him, his flamboyance. Filling Freddie's shoes. I think of his, I know that it's a struggle for anyone in a political arena putting out political things, but everyone sort of has to push their agendas of who they are, and you know, they're this, they're that, they're another thing. It'd be kind of cool if we could just be musicians and not have to push these different agendas. That'd be awesome. But then again, Freddie did it too. I mean, you think of We Are the Champions and stuff, you know, he sort of felt discriminated against, so he felt like he had to do, you know, to push the envelope of that as well too. But I'd love to just see more musical artistry rather than a lot of the politics that goes along with it. But with that said, let's dive right into Adam and see what he's made of here. It's a very short clip, but I think it typifies a lot of what he does with Queen. So. Can anybody find me? I said, can anybody find me? Yeah. Can anybody find me? Yeah. Yeah. Can anybody find me? Somebody to. That was the clip. Anyway, yeah, I could have picked all songs. So when you listen to him, yeah, maybe he's a little more shrill than Freddie in his upper register. And, you know, he definitely loves his runs and his chops and whatnot. But that's kind of his shtick. You know, he loves his high range. He loves his vocal runs and whatever. So you guys tell me what you think of when you think of Adam Lambert. What did I miss? Have you seen a show of his? Did you get to see him perform in Queen? Have you seen him some of his other original stuff or some of his band stuff on his own under his own name and whatnot? And I'm doing most of this by request. So put all this in the comments section of someone else you'd like to see me react to and do what makes this singer great. And definitely check out my next video.